Hey everyone, I'm Almar of almarsguides.com, and this video here is a quick update for my YouTube / website, and pretty much just a quick little video log. So, you may have noticed I have been putting out a lot of videos recently, and there are two reasons behind that. One is I've been feeling a bit under the weather, and I've just been having a lot of personal stuff going on, and I've had to take a quick little break from, you know, making guides, making videos, and stuff like that. Don't worry, I'm definitely going to be back. This is, of course, my job, and I love my job to death. So, you don't have to worry about me going anywhere, disappearing, or anything like that. I will be back, and I will be doing videos, you know, in the future. So, with that out of the way, I'd like to also give you the other reason as to why I haven't been putting out many videos recently, and that's because it takes a while for new farming locations to be discovered and to resurface and stuff like that. You can't expect, you know, a new farming location every day or something like that. That's just not how farming locations work. You know, you'll be lucky if they even add one with every patch, and if one is discovered, you know, in the long period of time between each patch and stuff like that. You know, a farming location isn't just going to pop up after one goes away. It takes months to discover, well, I'd say weeks to discover, and sometimes even months. There may never be a new farming location like Malkor's Leap for the rest of this game. You know, they might add something with the expansion, and they probably will, but until then, and until they add a bunch of new content, you're currently got Curseshore, Tunnel Farming, plus other events, and you have South Sun Cove. Aside from that, there is nothing else that is is new and added that you may be able to use for, you know, farming locations in the very near future. So I just wanted to get that out there because I get a lot of people sending me tells on literally a daily basis saying, hey man, is there any, you got any new farming locations? Like they come out on a daily basis or something like that. When, you know, I wanted to address that they don't at all. You know, you probably won't even get a new farming location for another few months. You're just going to be stuck with the typical South Sun, Citadel Flame, and Curseshore. And if you don't like those farming locations, well, then you're just pretty much kind of screwed, I guess. So, aside from that, I can't remember if I... Holy crap, there's a lot of Commanders in Lion's Arch right now. Aside from that, I can't remember if I said what I'm going to be doing is... this whole entire month of June, I'm going to be working on getting a level 80 of each class. Right now, I have one of each class made already. The only thing that I need to work on is leveling them up. So that is my future project and the main thing that I'm going to be working on for, you know, a few months and things of that nature. So definitely keep that in mind and, you know, I guess wish me luck. Hopefully by the time I'm all done and I get back into the swing of making videos again, what I'm going to be doing is making video guides on each and every single class, the build I use, how to play it, and stuff like that. That is one of the main reasons I'm leveling up, you know, each and every class and, you know, things of that nature. So another thing I'd like to address before this video ends is this unbreakable permanent harvesting sickle. Now I noticed gem prices didn't skyrocket as much as I predicted, but that is probably because this is a sickle and the axe is going to be, you know, where the big jabang is pretty much, because the axe is going to be used a lot more than this harvesting sickle, and that's definitely something you want to remember and keep in mind. Because since gems weren't too affected by this sickle, I can almost guarantee you that they're going to be affected heavily by the axe whenever it releases. And that's pretty much all there is to this video. Stick around, stay subscribed to me for future Guild Wars 2 and gaming content. I've also got a little bit into playing Path of Exile the past few days. Just because I needed the game as a break from the norm that I've been, you know, handling and dealing with. So I might be doing something new with that game for a little bit, but mostly right now I'm just going to be working on putting out a lot of Guild Wars 2 videos and a lot of Guild Wars 2 guides, because I know that's where all of my subscribers are. Aside from that, guys, that's pretty much all there is to it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, of course, as always, like, comment, subscribe to me for future gaming and Guild Wars 2 videos. And as always, guys, good luck. Happy hunting, and I'll catch you guys around the next video.